Every single year, the Earth radiates approximately 3 times humanity's energy consumption into outer space. Deep below the ground, a layer of melting hot materials constantly giving off heat, which is called geothermal energy. There are 2 ways to harness this power. The first is using a geothermal power plant, which directly exploits the energy from the Earth's crust. A long vertical hole is drilled down several kilometers deep. There, due to high pressure and temperature, boiling water flows into the well, generating an enormous amount of steam. This steam then runs through the pipes and power the turbine, which produces electricity. Lastly, the remaining water and steam are cooled down and pumped back into the crust, creating a loop that loses no water. The second method to utilize geothermal energy is easier to build, but smaller in scale. Instead of drilling several kilometers deep, we can take advantage of the heat by drilling just a few meters below the ground. There, the temperature is not boiling hot, around 20 to 30 degrees Celsius, but it's enough power to be useful. A geothermal pump injects water into the pipe under the ground. The water is warmed up by the Earth's heat. The hot water then circles the house to use and warm up the house. Although the cycle requires electricity for water pump, the energy produced is far greater, which makes the system efficient and sustainable. Geothermal energy, indeed, is cheaper, more efficient, and more environmentally friendly than fossil-fueled energy. But why the world doesn't use it anyway, despite all the advantages it seems? One of the biggest problems is the restriction of location. Geothermal power plants need to be built where the energy is accessible, such as Iceland or Japan. Secondly, volcanic eruption and earthquake can be triggered by excessive drilling, since these regions have magma rising near the crust. Although geothermal exploitation is believed to have no environmental footprint, greenhouse gases stored under the Earth crust can be released while drilling, though this amount is still lower than that produced by burning fossil fuel. Fortunately, these challenges can be addressed by technology advancement. For example, electronic monitoring can provide data to predict geological and volcanic activities. Specialized design system can control the gas's emission. Although geothermal power still has many hurdles that need to be overcome, this renewable energy holds great future to power our civilization.